Hi, I'm Tim Davis. Thanks for tuning in to CyberSalt's Basic Joomla channel. Today we've got a shout out to Mike Urquhart. Mike asked on YouTube, can you tell me how to change the height of the navigation bar in Gantry 5 Hydrogen Template? Mike, yes we can. Let's look at that on the computer right now. So Mike, in order to find the CSS that we're going to change to adjust the height of that navigation bar, I'm going to be using Google Chrome's Element Examiner. And so I have the basic Joomla site opened up here with the Gantry 5 template, with Hydrogen template. And I'm going to hit F12 to bring up the Element Inspector. And what we want to do is click on this button here on the left to select an element. And we're going to select just somewhere up here on that menu bar. That's probably a good guess there, since it's selecting the whole thing. And we'll look down. Now we have the elements on this side and what their properties are. Now, as I look over on the left-hand side here in this code, you'll see that there's a number of other options in the hierarchy here. And I want to just keep highlighting till I get to the element that still is at the top and selects what we want. And this one, G container, it goes right across the top. But I don't see anything in here setting the same color that is there. So I'm going to go up one higher to G navigation to the section. That still highlights right across. And when I look over here, I see here's the background color that's set. So this is probably the CSS that we want to change. So I'm going to type by just clicking here to add a new line to the CSS to test it. I'm going to type height, hit enter, and then I'm going to type 40, and we'll do 40 pixels, px. And we'll see right away, as soon as I finish typing the x, this top bar goes lower to, has the height that is lower. So the next thing that we want to do, though, is we need to find some other CSS to change, because as you can see, the white of the home menu there and is a different height as well. So first of all, before moving on, I'm going to left click and select this HTML, because you're going to want to put that in our custom HTML page in the Rockettheme template. And I'm going to copy that and we'll put it over here on another screen. I just have a notepad open and here is, I'm just going to paste that CSS there and we'll get ready for a new line to paste the next things. All right, so the next thing that we want to do is somehow change the height of this white. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go slowly down through the HTML levels here until only that white is highlighted. I might actually get the point where I run out, but here this arrow, you see we can click and go to the next level. We'll highlight that. There we go, we've got it. That's the active menu. So when we click on that, we'll look over here, and we'll see here the background white color is being set there for G navigation, G main nav, top level. So once again, I'm going to type in there, H-E-I-G-H-T. We're going to add a new line. Let's do the same height, of course, 40 pixels. And now that white has changed in its height. So we're making progress. Again, I'm going to select all that CSS that we've just edited. We actually don't need to repeat the background color. So what we'll do is I'll bring my notepad over here and we'll paste that in there. But I'm going to take out this background color line and just delete it. We have some weird double spacing happening in here, but that won't affect when we paste later on. All right, next you notice that the title home is now right on the very bottom. It's not at the middle of the white spot there. So let's go down another level over on the left and select, there we go, we have the AG menu item container. We click on that and now we're looking for something that will make that home move up. And as we scroll down here, we see G main nav top level padding. Now this checkbox here, we can just uncheck that and see if that has any effect on what we're working on. It does. So we're in the right area. And we want to adjust this first number to remove the padding that's at the top and so it can move up a bit. So I've already been experimenting with this. So we're going to go and put in 0.45 REM. And as we change it, we see that it's centered nicely up there. So again, down here, we'll just hit enter. And once again, we have some CSS that we want to select and copy and put in our list of CSS that we've edited. All right. Now, there we go. Everything seems to be pretty good there, except as you'll notice now, if you have a submenu under this menu, you're going to end up with the thicker amounts, the thicker sizes. Now, you might be fine with that. And if that's okay, if you don't mind having the thicker boxes, that is that's great. And the navigation bar is a lesser height and your problems are solved. If you want these other areas, the submenus, to have the same height as that, then what you need to do is continue to go down through the HTML code on this side and find where the height is set for other things such as a submenu, and just continue to repeat the steps of hunting down the CSS for changing what you want to change. So it can be a little bit tricky sometimes on templates, because the first thing that you click on to examine might not even have anywhere that you can adjust the height of something, or the width, or the color. But by going up through the preceding HTML and using the tool as I've demonstrated here, that will let you edit the CSS, find the CSS for different elements that you want to change. And of course, the final step is to take all of this custom CSS code that you have that we've made changes to, and paste that into the custom.scss file that is in the template folder that you set up for changing the CSS. And I have a tutorial on that already. I'll put a card up that will link to that video, and I'll also put a link to that video in the description for this video. I will also be posting this CSS information in the bottom. I'm going to remove a little bit more because here, for example, we only change height. So we don't want to keep duplicating more than is necessary. So that's how to change the height of that navigation bar in Gantry 5 Hydrogen. So Mike and anybody else, why not give the video a like and subscribe to the channel? That would be great. Thanks for watching, and enjoy working on your Joomla site.